We will shift to the second paper now. It's on awareness and its associates of occupational hazards and safety practices among medical laboratory technologists working in government tertiary care health institutions in Colombo district. Karunaratna BJ and Veera Singh. The presenter is Karunaratna BJ.
Our study was awareness and its associates of occupational hazards and safety practices among medical laboratory technologists or their MLTs working in government tertiary care health institutions in Colombo district. A hazard is any source of potential damage, harm or adverse health effect on someone or something. The hazards which are experienced at the workplaces are known as occupational hazards. As evidenced in current Sri Lanka with the COVID-19 pandemic, MLTs are a very special group of healthcare workers who are very important in patient diagnosis. Meanwhile, in their service, they are exposed to a variety of occupational hazards. So, therefore, their awareness of occupational hazards and safety practices is of utmost importance. Previous literature on the topic, which were done globally and in Sri Lanka, has mainly focused only one type of occupational hazards, such as biological hazards, ergonomic hazards, etc. Only a handful of studies have analyzed the overall hazard profile of laboratory workers. Therefore, current study was designed and conducted to focus on the awareness of the MLTs regarding all the types of occupational hazards and safety practices. General objective of the study was to assess the level of awareness and its associated factors on occupational hazards and safety practices among the MLTs working in government tertiary care health institutions in Colombo district. Specific objectives were to assess the level of awareness based on their knowledge and attitudes and to determine the socio-demographic and occupation-related factors associated with their awareness level. A cross-sectional study was conducted in all the government tertiary care health institutions in Colombo district, recruiting all the eligible MLTs who were currently employed during the data collection period. So, a total of 358 MLTs were recruited to the study. A pre-tested self-administered questionnaire was used to collect data. Associates of the awareness level were determined by using chi-square test, placing the significance at 0.05 level. Ethical clearance for the study was obtained. Out of 358 MLTs, 326 responded, giving a response rate of 91.1%. As you all can see, this is the distribution of the awareness scores of the participants, and it followed a normal distribution with a mean score of 76.1 and a standard deviation of 9.2. Median was 76.2 with an interquartile range from 69.5 to 81.7. Then, the awareness scores of the participants were categorized into two groups as satisfactory and not satisfactory based on a cutoff value of 75, which was close to both the mean and the median of the distribution. Among the participants, the majority, 57.4% or 187 participants, had satisfactory level of awareness of occupational hazards and safety practices. In the determination of the associates, the association between the awareness level and the socio-demographic characteristics was not statistically significant. However, the association between the experience of the participants at the current station and the awareness level revealed a statistically significant association with a p-value of 0.047. Out of 358 participants, 265 or 81.3% had received some training on occupational health and safety ever in their career. So, when the analysis was performed, only among those 265 participants who had received any training, a statistically significant association was revealed between their awareness level and the number of training sessions they have participated in with a p-value of 0.039. So in conclusion, the majority of the MLTs working in government tertiary care health institutions in Colombo district had satisfactory level awareness of occupational hazards and safety practices. However, our study recommends that occupational safety and health of the MLTs should be further improved, prioritized and regularly monitored at institutional level to maintain the high quality standards. These are my references. I want to acknowledge all the heads of the institutions in which the study was carried out, all the chief MLTs and MLTs who have participated in my study. Thank you.
Okay, again, thank you for sticking to time. And the paper is now open for the questions.
show how many males and females were there in the MLT group? Were there the six difference?
MLTs? Yes, madam. There was a sex difference, madam. Actually, the majority were females, but there was no statistically significant difference between the awareness level, madam. Difference was not statistically significant.
Okay.
The majority of the MLT population were females.
Yes.
Any other questions?
Yes.
Comments? Yes, please.
You mentioned that in the literature only a single variable
yes.
was explored. So when you conducted your study, did you find any area that was particularly neglected or where more training would be required?
Actually, madam, it's more or less the I thought it as ergonomic hazards, because everybody is focusing on biological hazards and standard precautions. So what I thought was it's ergonomic hazards, because in my study the people were least aware of the ergonomic hazards.
Okay, for the interest of time, thank you for presenting your paper and our normal way of appreciation.
Thank you.